Hey y'all, it's Steve, Hobo with Wood. In today's video, we're going to revisit the Brilliance Laser Marking Spray. We're not going to be playing with wood, whether we're going to be marking some stainless steel medallions. And we're going to be doing that with the diode. And this is so easy, so simple. Hang around. If you're marking metals, you need to watch this video. Before we jump into Lightburn and set up these medallions, these are jewelry grade, high polished stainless steel medallions. And I'm actually going to put the Datsun 280Z logo on the medallion. I hope that shows up. I'm going to move it around a little bit so that the light doesn't reflect constantly, but that is a super nice image. And it is permanent. You can feel that. It is a nice image and it is not coming off. But first I want to tell you a little bit about the Brilliance Laser Marking Sprays. Now I have tried this. This says on the can for use with CO2, fiber, and YAG lasers. It does not say that it is for use with a diode. But I have tested it on the diode and I have used it multiple times successfully with the diode. And I had a really in-length video on this product, which I'll put in the description below and we'll put it on the end screen. And it has real-time testing of this product. And many, many of my viewers have bought this since me talking about it and have experienced the same level of success. But the reason I want to share this with you is multi-reasons. It's not marketed to diode users, but it works with the diode if you follow directions and you test your material. Not all material is friendly to being marked with. So it does require some testing. But if it doesn't work for you, it could be the material or you don't have the right power, the right speeds, whatever, but that's why you test with a product. But there are lots of marking sprays on the market, and I always shied away from buying any because they were always so dad blasted expensive. This is not cheap, but it's pennies, relatively speaking, compared to the other stuff on the market. Let's take a look at their website here. This is the Brilliance metal marking sprays in the aerosol cans. And they offer it in a couple different formulations, a couple different colors, a couple sizes. But if you're marking metals, I'm telling you this stuff works. Go ahead and bite the bullet and buy the 12 ounce can. This is the black. They offer it here in a red. And it says it's red, and then it goes on to say it's copper tone. But I have not had great success with that, either with my diode or the CO2. It does have a reddish, coppery, rusty look to it, but it's just not, it's not what you would hope for it to be when you hear red or even copper. But the black is strong, vibrant. It's a really, really good image. But you can see here, they offer a 12-ounce can for $54.95. And they have a 2-ounce can for $24.45. I'm simple, but two $25 cans is $50. And two $25 cans only gets you 4 ounces, whereas $54 gets you 12 ounces. Get the 12-ounce can. Don't waste your money on that 2 ounce, because if it doesn't work with the metals you have, if you're wanting to mark metals, then this works. You just got to find the right metals. So when I was looking for a way to mark metals, the one thing that everybody talked about was Surmark, and hear this. They're averaging, this is on Amazon. There's $100 for the 12-ounce can. There's a 2-ounce for $20. $102 for a 12-ounce. You know, Sir Mark is expensive, and I was not going to spend $100 for a can of spray for hobby use. Even if it was, if I was making money, at $100 for a 12-ounce can, you've got to add so much money to your product to make it profitable. So when I found this Brilliance for half the price, I said, well, I've got to try this. I got to see how well does it work. And boy, howdy, does it work extremely well. Again, I'll put a link to that video down below so you can go watch the full testing of that. But just, I do use the product. I use the product. I'm not just promoting the product to promote something. A friend has a classic 280Z, and it got a little puncture in the door panel. And you can't go buy a 1980 door panel replacement anymore. So, and you can make little repairs to the interiors, but you can then see that where that's been done. So we're trying to figure out a better way to hide that repair. So we come up with the idea of, why not put a badge over it? If it looks like it came from the factory, get the repair made, and then we'll cover it up. So we found these jewelry quality medallions. And then I use my Brilliance metal laser spray in black. Used Lightburn to create that image. Now we'll put some 3M backing on here, or some, maybe even that headliner spray, and glue that to the door panel. And that's going to cover up the repair. It's going to look great, and it's going to be pennies versus a discontinued or hundreds of dollars for a door panel. If you're not marking metals and you would like to, but you are always afraid of the price, this is an option for you. So let's take a look, a quick look at what this process involves. Okay, so the piece has dried. It's actually ready to engrave, but I'm not ready to start engraving. We're going to use Lightburn's center finder to position this where I need it to. I've already focused the laser. Now we're going to move the laser into position. Let's see here. We'll get her close. Now, you do not want to have air assist on when using this spray, because air assist, as I showed you outside when spraying this powder, it can be blown off if you're using your air assist. So turn your air assist off. And we're going to use laser tools, center finder. We're going to move this into position. And this takes just a second to get set up. Okay, that should be the center. Now we'll move the artwork to the center of that toolpath. We'll check the framing. And I'm satisfied with that. Now I'm doing this particular burn at 5 millimeters a second and 100% power, or 300 millimeters a minute and 100% power on a 10 watt diode with no air assist. And let's start her up. And this is just a nasty old paper cloth. No water, no cleaners. That just wipes right off. So that was really easy. Extremely easy cleanup. A couple of quick spurts of the spray, it dries in 5 to 7 minutes. It's very fast, very friendly, and it produces an excellent image. I hope that's showing up well on the camera there. But I've tested a few lasers. I don't know enough technological stuff about the lasers to know what's great and what, you know, but I know what works and what don't work, and that's why I don't have that. That's why I'm working with the Comgrow now. Let's put it that way. I've been real happy with that. I've got some more coming I'm going to try out, but the Comgrow's been my happiest I've been with so far. But materials I've tested, I've shared some of those on Hobo with Wood and the shop supplies. I try to buy premium product. I go with the AAA grade Baltic birch. I go with some really good stuff. But I found that there it is. This stuff is phenomenal. And it's not supposed to be working with the diode. But it is. I do. I use it on my CO2 and my diode. And I did not mention that there's a 100% satisfaction guarantee or your money back. Now, I don't know if that's going to apply if you buy it and you try to use it for your diode and you don't have the best of luck because it's not marketed for the diode. They do have a 100% satisfaction guarantee and free technical support. But since it's not marketed to the diode user, I don't know that they're going to be able to help you much. So I'm interrupting this video because after recording it, I reached out to Brilliance to find out what they would do in the event you contacted them for technical support with your diode laser. And they are willing to try and help you work through any issues of not getting the desired results as long as you understand this was not marketed or designed to be used with a diode. You can get positive results with it as long as you're capable and willing to do the necessary testing to find the right speed and power settings to get the desired results from your diode. But it is on you to figure out what will work with your diode and this spray. But it will work in the right conditions. But I'm promising you, it works. The only time I've had an issue is with an inferior metal. So the qualities of the metals will make a difference on how well the image is reproduced. But in any case, if you've been marking metals and using and had success with using the zinc oxides, zinc coatings and the white spray paints and stuff like that, if it's worked on the metals that you have, this will work. It'll work 10 times faster and 1,000 times easier to clean up than any other method I've worked with in close to a year now. So you can use the coupon Hobo with Wood, just like it's on the screen there. Hobo with Wood, spaces in between each one, to save 10% on the Brilliance website. I'll have the link down below that'll take you to the Brilliance site. Coupon code Hobo with Wood saves you 10%. You need to get a can of this if you're marking metals. So hopefully this helps you out. And until the next video, I'm out.